I've been noticing on social media a lot of people posting about lymphatic drainage massages.
Yeah.
And since they're posting, I'm wondering if it's worth it, but I don't know that much information about it.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Lymph glands are all through your body, right?
They
collect our toxins or process them.
Thank you, Dr. Rachel, as I always say. Thank you, Doc. So the lymphatic system is so important. You're right. It consists of lymph nodes and so many other things. Mm-hmm. And our lymphatic system helps to deal with fluctuating fluid in our body, and it helps to get rid of damaged cells and things like that. This is what I say about the lymphatic massage. They are popping up everywhere. And actually, we've got some graphics. First of all, like the massage part, usually what people have done is like gentle massage, using gentle pressure around sort of the lymphatic areas. This is one technique that massage places are offering throughout the country. But there's also other techniques too, that some places are offering a lymphatic massage suit, where you literally get suited up in a
suit.
Yep.
Look at
her. You get
She's
to put a suit on.
She's in the Blue Man Group.
You get a suit, and then to your point, Rachel, you mentioned these rollers here. Like, this is rose quartz and this is jade, and the thought is by using them, it can help sort of redistribute lymph and things like that. Usually, these places throughout the country are claiming that it helps get rid of toxins. It'll help make you healthier, make you your immune system be better. But I gotta tell you guys, as a doctor, I'm skeptical. Now, let me tell you, there are people who really need lymphatic massage. Those are our breast cancer patients who may have lymphedema in an arm.
Right.
Or may have lymphedema, other people who have just lymphedema in any other part in their body. Or people who are post-surgical. These are patients who rely on lymphatic massage from a licensed, certified person as part of their treatment.
As part of their physical therapy.
Exactly.
Right.
But if you're totally healthy, and you ain't got a lymph problem going on,
it's not gonna do you any extra good.
I don't know that I have any good evidence that tells you it's going to get rid of toxins or help your immune system. So I say, if
but
you like it.
But these things are great for puffy eyes.
So I say, if you like the feeling of the lymph massage, if you like the feeling of it and you have no contraindications, maybe try it because you like the feeling of it. But will it change your life drastically if you don't have underlying medical conditions? I'm not sure that I can say that's the case.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
So I'm in my 50s.
Okay.
I've seen a lot of information about the shingles vaccine.
Yes.
I've seen commercials, but I've never gotten it, and
yes.
I don't know what to do at this point.
Okay.
Did you have chickenpox when you were a little kid?
No.
Okay. Oh, I did. I had it.
I didn't have it. I didn't have chickenpox. Yeah. So, okay, you are not alone. Let's first talk about what shingles is. So a lot of people wonder, shingles is actually a very painful rash that happens on one side of the body. We see our graphic here. This is a classic picture of shingles. One side of the face or the body, and it typically happens in a band-like formation. You start out with vesicles, and over 2 to 4 weeks, they start to crust over. But you can get fever, malaise, and just feel really kind of punky. But the other thing about it is this rash, guys, is super, super painful. It can burn and itch. And I know you guys are like, so wait, how do we even get shingles? Let's talk about this. First thing is, shingles and chickenpox are caused by the same virus. And our graphic here, this is somebody who's got chickenpox. All the little red spots, see? And the purple circle is the varicella zoster virus. What happens is, you've got the chickenpox, right? There it goes, it's working. Over a few weeks, you get rid of your chickenpox, but that virus lays dormant in your nerves.
Oh, that's so creepy, it's in my back.
Or it can be in any nerve. And then what happens in some people is that it may reactivate, and if it does, it reactivates and forms shingles, and that's what we're seeing.
So is it only possible for people to get shingles that have had chickenpox?
That's not necessarily the case, and I'm gonna answer that. First of all, a lot of people wonder, you know, who's going to have this reactivate? 1 in 3 people actually get the shingles, and we think it happens in people who are older and weakened immune systems and things like this. But get this, over 99% of the people who are over the age of 40 have gotten chickenpox, whether we remember it or not. And that's why, regardless of whether we've gotten chickenpox or not, because I haven't had chickenpox, the CDC still recommends the shingles vaccine for those who qualify for it. That makes sense?
So
you still are eligible for it, yes.
So if I never had chickenpox.
That's right.
And I was tested that I've never had chickenpox, I can still get the vaccine for shingles?
The CDC is still recommending it regardless of whether you remember getting chickenpox or not. And remember, this is not for everybody. Most people will qualify for the shingles vaccine, but there are some people who shouldn't take it, okay? But yeah, I would talk to your doctor and see what they say about that. So,
but generally over 50, the CDC says yes.
Get the shingles vaccine. It's a brand new vaccine, over 90% effective, super important.